Everybody makes himself inconspicuous when the captain asks for volunteers for night patrol. But one man, the pure warrior, has already rubbed a burnt cork on his face. He believes winning the war is his personal responsibility. Joseph Bonanno, a man of honor. The autobiography of Joseph Bonanno. Many people know about the five families in the outfit, but Upstate was a hotbed for mob activity. You had the Magaddino crime family in Buffalo. Rochester had its own crime family headed by Frank Valenti and then the A and B teams. Binghamton was run by the Bufalinos. Utica had a powerful crew with Falcone. And various other families have operated in the northern sector of New York State at one time. The Magaddino crime family, or the R, began in 1910 and was later known as the Bonanno crime family. Their territory was said to include Buffalo, Niagara Falls, Syracuse, Rochester, Utica, Ontario, Northwest Pennsylvania, and Las Vegas. It began when Pepe Bonanno, along with the Undertaker Magaddino, immigrated to the United States in 1909 from Castellamare del Golfo, Italy. Pepe was a family don of La Cosa Nostra in the seaside town they came from, in Sicily. While Stefano was leading his own crew inside of this syndicate, Magaddino faction, Stefano Magaddino moved to Niagara Falls, New York, then in later years further north to Lewiston, a town on the Niagara River facing the Canadian border. He was a successful mortician operating Magaddino Memorial Chapel Funeral Home in Niagara Falls. He made his real money running a profitable bootlegging business by smuggling wine and spirits across the Niagara River into New York State, supplying speakeasies in Niagara Falls for tourists, on top of serving Buffalo and other smaller towns. His luxuriant business most likely led to a lifestyle that must have become arduous to upkeep when Prohibition ended. This is where he and his crime family branched out into extortion, loan sharking, carjacking, illegal gambling, and labor racketeering on top of other cleaner businesses such as taxi companies, linen service, and other public operations throughout the region. Magaddino's crime family held stake in underworld territories of upstate and western New York, namely Buffalo. Buffalo bordered Canada, and Stefano situated his enterprise on Lake Erie. With alcohol distribution during Prohibition and various rackets situated from the Mohawk River as far east as Amsterdam, New York, even Pennsylvania, going the other way as far west as Youngstown, Ohio, and up in Canada from Fort Erie to Toronto, Ontario, even as far north as Montreal, Quebec. Magaddino led his Buffalo family through its glory years in his age as the most bountiful and powerful La Cosa Nostra don now in time. He was an old-style boss who preferred to stay behind the scenes and not draw any attention to himself or his criminal activities if possible. Due to his territory's remoteness and the vast amount of territory he controlled and being geographically shielded from the inner family squabbles of the New York City-based families, he was held in high regard and was at times called upon to be a mediator involving territorial disputes between crime families based there. He was a part of Lucky Luciano's commission and more involved than most of the other families. The Undertaker was the older stepbrother of the Bonanno brothers, and Pepe Bonanno had an older brother named Stefano too, not to be confused with their close ally Magaddino. Stefano Bonanno was an advisor to Giuseppe, and they had a younger brother named Salvatore Bonanno. Giuseppe and older brother and advisor Stefano Bonanno were killed in 1902 due to an old world vendetta originally started back in Sicily that had raged in Trapani province. Then the Magaddino faction and Bonanno family teamed with each other, feuding against the Bucalato clan and a powerful mafia group who also maneuvered for control of the town's rackets and were at constant odds with the Magaddino and Bonventri families. Salvatore, Bonanno's younger brother, took revenge on the Bucalatos with murder-for-hire group Good Killers, led by Vito Bonventri. Salvatore had a son and named him after his older brother that he looked up to, Giuseppe. Giuseppe grew up to be Joseph Bonanno, a native of Castellamarese who would rise to rule a New York crime family. He explained the feud situation in his autobiography, noting that his cousin Stefano
Magaddino and Gaspar Malazzo came into conflict with rival groups in our world. Very often, these rivals were friends and relatives of enemies in Sicily. The Magaddino family was not alone in having members in America. The Bucalato family did also. They were archenemies in Castellamare, and archenemies they remained in Brooklyn.
Salvatore brought his wife and only child to America, and Giuseppe became Joe to his first grade classmates. The boy had a great time in Brooklyn, New York, and his father would take him on walks through the bustling city streets, and they would stop at the Nickelodeon. But to Joe's disappointment, they had to go back to Italy due to the Castellamarese War. He had fallen in love with the American experience, and when he came back to Italy, he was called the American Kid. His earliest memories were America, but he spent his childhood absorbing the tough nature of his land, riding a horse by the sea, imagining himself as a knight, fighting for honor, or a captain of a ship, sailing the globe. Expecting to be a man of influence and power, he was raised in certain rhetorical traditions of honor or deference to a great man. His idyllic childhood was cut short at age 11 when his father drafted to fight for Italy and returned home badly wounded. His dying words to his son when he came home was, "Your name is Bonanno. Always be proud of your name." 5 years later, his mother died as well. Just a teenager, he inherited what's left of his family's fortune. Developing shrewdness due to growing up fast on his own at age 15, he was soon disgusted with his uncle's feuding over inheritance in Sicily, and he decided to take what he needed, leaving Castellamare del Golfo behind. He enrolled in a college in Palermo, and his ambition was to become a naval officer in the Italian Merchant Marine. He was about to accomplish that, but Palermo eventually took a hit from fascism when Mussolini felt Sicily deserved to be punished. Joe denounced Mussolini, forming a radical student organization, but the Naval Academy kicked him out. And when Joe noticed Mussolini targeting mafia-connected people with torture and murder, he decided it's time to go home. During the protracted conflict in Sicily back in 1916, Stefano's brother Pietro Magaddino was shotgunned off his horse one day while riding in the mountains of Castellamare. His assassination was thought to have been the work of Capo Francesco Bucalato and soldier Camillo Caiozzo. Several murders between the faction took place in Castellamare. As Caiozzo arrived in Ellis Island aboard the steamer La Savoy on June 28, 1920, likely fleeing Magaddino retribution, word of his offense was sent from Sicily. The good killers were assigned to carry out the vendetta. Caiozzo initially settled with his mother Maria and siblings on East 12th Street in Manhattan. After a year, the good killers apparently decided they could get to Caiozzo easiest by using his boyhood friend Fontana to catch him off guard. Fontana claimed he learned of the murder plot when three of the gang leaders backed him into a hallway, pressing the muzzles of their pistols into Fontana, and they told him to swear to commit the crime, or they would blow him to pieces. Fontana had seen enough of the good killer's actions in Detroit to know the great position he was in. He gave in to the pressure and took an oath to murder Caiozzo. The two old chums became reacquainted in the summer of 1921, might have even moved in together briefly. Fontana proposed a combination business trip and vacation in New Jersey. Caiozzo had recently sold an embroidery business earning $600, and Fontana urged him to invest the proceeds in a disorderly house, also known as a brothel. He offered to put his old friend in touch with a New Jersey acquaintance who managed such an establishment near Shark River in Monmouth County. Fontana suggested they spend a few days there and enjoy some hunting in the countryside. The pair arrived Thursday, July 26th at the Riverview Inn in Neptune City, The inn was managed by Salvatore Chiarevo, also known locally as Salvatore Rose, who ran the disorderly house located in the next municipality, Asbury Park. On Saturday, Caiozzo took a train back to New York City. The purpose of his trip is unknown, but while in the city, he visited his family. It was the last time Maria Caiozzo would see her son alive.